In the first video, we learned to separate deer into three age classes. Fawns, those 1.5 years of age, and those 2.5 or older, based on the tooth replacement part of the technique. In this series, we're going to focus on the tooth wear part of the technique, which will allow us to age deer 2.5 years of age and older. In the earlier video, we used the tooth replacement part of the technique to assign deer to three age classes. And to do that, we had to identify the individual teeth on a deer's lower jaw, and also to distinguish between the adult and the baby form of that third premolar. The next part of this technique, the tooth wear part, requires us to understand and recognize the erosion of teeth over time. And to understand that, we have to learn two terms that are parts of the actual teeth themselves, that being dentine and enamel. And if you think about a sharp mountain peak, with the crest of that mountain or the outer coating being the enamel and the dark inner core of that material being the dentine, that will give you an idea of what we're looking at. And imagine that sharp mountain peak slowly being eroded over time. And as that peak gets worn, it appears that that dark inner coating or the dentine gets wider and wider as that tooth gets closer to its base. And we will apply standardized criteria to the width of that dentine or dark material to assign an age. For the wear part of the technique, we actually slide over one tooth to the first molar, or the tooth number 4 if you're coming from the front of the jawbone. That's because it's the first molar and it's the oldest tooth in the deer's jaw. It's the first permanent tooth that deer received. And for this part of the technique, we're only looking at these sharp ridges which are on the inside to me of the tooth. So the high outer ridges are the ones you want to focus this technique on, not these lower ridges across the bottom. So again, we're looking here at these higher ridges. And what you want to do is, again, go to that fourth tooth and look at the dark material inside those two crests of that same tooth. That tooth has two parts. And look at the width of that dark material or dentine relative to one strip of the white enamel next to it. And what we're going to be asking ourselves is how wide that is compared to that one strip. And that will be the basis of our technique from here forward. Now that we've already used the tooth replacement part of the technique to assign deer to one of three age classes, again, fawns, 1.5, or at least 2.5 years of age, we now bring our focus to the fourth tooth, or the first molar. And again, what we're focusing on are these high ridges on the fourth tooth, and we're looking at the dark strip of material called dentine versus the white coating next to it, which is the enamel. And we ask ourselves a very simple question. Is that dark material in these ridges, again on the fourth tooth, is that dark material twice as wide or thick as one strip of the enamel next to it? In other words, one adjacent side of that white enamel. In this case, it is clearly not as wide or twice as wide. It's far less. So we stop at age 2.5, which is where we started. Again, we knew that animal is at least 2.5 years of age because it's not a fawn, a yearling, based on tooth replacement. So let's take a look at a 3.5-year-old. On a 3.5-year-old animal, again starting on the fourth tooth, you'll notice that the dentine or dark material on these high crests is clearly twice as wide as one strip of the enamel next to it. So you add 1 year, so it's at least 3.5. Again, we started at 2.5, because we knew it was not a fawn, a 1.5, we knew it was at least 2.5. So we add 1 year of age here, and we slide over one tooth. You can see, asking that same question, is that dentine or dark material twice as thick or wide as one strip of the enamel next to it? Here you say no, so you go back to the age that you just came from, which was 3.5. On a 4.5-year-old animal, again starting on the fourth tooth from the front of the jaw, you can again ask yourself, is that dentine twice as wide or wider than one strip of the enamel on these high crests? The answer is yes. In this case, it clearly is. You add 1 year. So again, we started at age 2.5. Because we knew it was not a fawn, a yearling, so we started age 2.5. It's at least 3.5, we slide over one tooth. In this case, the answer again is yes, that dentine is twice as wide as one strip of the enamel next to it, so that animal's at least 4.5 years of age. We slide over to the last tooth, or the third molar, and it is not. So we, again, and each time you say no, you move back to the previous age you assigned that animal. So this is a 4.5-year-old animal. An animal that's at least 5.5 years of age, again starting on the fourth tooth or first molar, you can easily and quickly see that the dentine is more than twice as wide as one strip of the enamel next to it. So that animal's at least 3.5. You move over to the next tooth, again asking yourself the same question. Again, you get yes to the question. It is twice as wide as the enamel next to it, so the animal is at least 4.5 years of age. Slide over again to the last tooth in the sequence and see again, the answer is yes. So you've answered yes to all three of those questions on all three of those molars, so that animal is at least 5.5 years of age. In the case an animal is clearly even older than 5.5 years of age, such as 6.5 or 7.5, again, you'll quickly be able to say yes to the dentine enamel question. Yes, that is more than twice as wide on the first molar. It is on the second. It is on the third. So then you circle back to that fourth tooth or first molar and ask yourself, is that starting to dish or flatten? And if the answer is yes, that animal is at least 6.5 years of age. Once you're at 6.5 years of age, most biologists stop trying to assign individual ages to those animals because of the decreasing accuracy of the technique once the animals are very old based on a number of variables. So at that time, you simply say the animal is 6.5 plus and is more than adequate for management purposes. Hope you found this video series on aging whitetails after harvest using the tooth replacement and wear technique very useful. The next video in our series will actually be a quiz so you can put your skills to the test. Before doing so, though, I encourage you to get your hands on some Jawbones, review the first two parts of this video series, and you might also consider obtaining the aging poster that we have through the Quality Deer Management Association at QDMA.com.